Hey there, peeps, it's me once again, and I'm back for another exclusive interview. This time, our special guests are no other than the co-founders of Stobox. First, we have the Chief Operating Officer, Mr. Ross Shemeliak, and the Head of Business Analytics and Strategy, Mr. Borys Pikalov. Guys, thanks for your time here with us, and welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for your invitation.
Okay, so today is an opportunity for me and to all of you who are watching this video right now to learn more on what Stobox is coming from, our amazing guest speaker today on its ecosystem, use cases, and how it could make a difference in the crypto, blockchain, and DeFi space. So before we begin, I would like to say hello to all of our subscribers and viewers here who are watching our interview session right now. So before we go to the questions, make sure you don't forget to smash the like button, hit subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for you to stay notified about my latest videos and interviews regarding cryptocurrencies, blockchain technology, and DeFi. And you can follow my social media channels displayed here on the screen or in my YouTube description. Okay, so guys, are we all set?
We are ready.
All right, so first things first, before we get to know about Stobox, let's take time to introduce yourselves to our subscribers and viewers who are watching us right now on YouTube. So if you don't mind, could you share more about yourselves, how you get started in exploring the crypto, blockchain, and DeFi space, and ended up co-founding Stobox? So who would like to go first?
Borys, please.
Okay. Previously, before Stobox, I've been a researcher doing studies on theoretical physics and also general societal trends as my additional hobby. And while doing this kind of researches and studies, I found about the importance of blockchain and how it can transform the markets for capital, governance, and general relations entities. And I understood that in order to maximize the impact and do something more meaningful, I have to switch from being solely researching an analyst to actually being in the business and helping to build the infrastructure and ecosystem to enable the positive benefits the DLT can bring to the market.
Okay, so thank you very much, Borys. So, Ross, it's your turn.
Yes, since high school, I have been very interested in economics in general, which prompted me to study in depth, and I spent 2 years in a German school where I continued to study economics, and I started my career in finance in a company that advised clients on investments in US stock market and commodities. And I have been following a lot of magazines and website resources about new technologies and innovation. And in 2015, I saw an article about cryptocurrencies, about blockchain. And in my life, I have also practiced traditional and crypto trading. And monitoring the trends of the blockchain, I learned about STO and I started digging deeper and recognized their huge potential impact. And a friend of mine offered me to participate in Stobox project, and I was glad to join.
Wow, all I can say, it was great to hear from you guys about your journey towards the crypto, blockchain, and DeFi space, as well as ended up co-founding Stobox. So hopefully that in many years to come, you guys could make a difference with Stobox as one of the crypto projects in the space that we should take a look. Okay, so thank you very much for that wonderful introduction. Now, my next question is all about the mission and vision. I know that most of our audience here are crypto and blockchain enthusiasts, and they really wanted to learn about the company's mission and vision in this disruptive global economy. Okay, guys, could you share with us about Stobox's mission and vision for us right here?
Sure. Our mission is quite ambitious, to say at least. So it is to reduce all barriers to the movement of capital to maximize the economic value it creates. So now let me explain it in simpler terms. The economic value, that is the wealth for everybody, for us, the goods and services, the innovation, is created when capital money is used efficiently and it goes to the most efficient businesses who create innovation, who create the best products and services. The problem is that due to multiple barriers to the movement of capital, such as the technology barriers that make investment more complex than it should be due to the legal barriers that limit the potential for participation of retail investors and many similar things. The movement of capital is constrained and it cannot go to the most efficient businesses. For example, small businesses such as startups, such as Asset Stobox, such as many others, can grow a few hundred percent year over year, while stock market on average grows 8 to 10% over year. So in the sector of small businesses, much more economic value is created. However, much more money, especially recently printed money, goes to stock market and this kind of investment instead of small businesses. And it is, amongst other things, related to the complexity of investing in small businesses, to the lack of infrastructure, to legal constraint, etc., and to the limited opportunity for cross-border investment, to the complexity of evaluating investment opportunities. So our goal at Stobox is to remove these barriers to make fundraising for businesses and especially small and medium enterprises easier, and therefore to promote general economic growth through the efficient use of capital. Another example is in the developing, this is especially relevant in developing economies where capital markets are underdeveloped. And even from our own experiences in developing countries, people are often limited with investing only in real estate and other opportunities are not available, which means that money, instead of going into the creation of economic value and innovation, goes into inflating property prices and making them less accessible. So there are many adverse social consequences because of limits in the movement of capital. And this is what we want to change with, first of all, introduction of the technology infrastructure for tokenization, which makes things in which capital goes, that the shares and financial instrument transacted and created with more ease and more accessible to small and medium businesses.
Mm-hmm. So we provide for the private companies possibility to attract capital from investors around the world. So we're providing the tokenization services to make their shares tokenized and make them tradable. And we are building one ecosystem for their real business for and small and medium enterprises to completely shifting online, to attract capital online, to manage their cap table online, to trade their securities and to operate. And COVID-19 shows us that a lot of companies, they need to be online and they find the solution because they can't fly, they can't meet each other. And that's what they search.
All right. So that's a very interesting mission and vision that you have for Stobox. So I hope all of you here who are watching our interview right now are learning about it. So let's just hope that with your strong mission and vision, you guys could make a huge difference in this industry, especially that you have mentioned that we are under the COVID-19 pandemic, but that it doesn't stop us from reaching its full potential. So guys, thank you very much for that. Now, about this next question of mine, this is really important for all of you who are watching us right now, because I know most of you here have no idea or a little bit of idea or something that you didn't understand yet about Stobox. So it's all about their entire ecosystem, especially on how it works for businesses, investors, and enthusiasts around the world. Now guys, if you don't mind, could you share to us how Stobox ecosystem works, especially your competitive advantages and benefits for users like me?
Sure. So the focus of our ecosystem, especially for the investors, is on providing you access to all kinds of crypto assets for you to be able to create a broad portfolio of decent tokens. So on one hand, via our tokenization services and companies who we help with doing token offering, you can invest in more traditional businesses, that is in security tokens backed by real assets such as real estate, traditional businesses, manufacturing projects, film projects, etc. On the other hand, we are launching a crypto exchange, the focus of which will be not on advanced trading mechanics, but on decent utility tokens issued by good project, the so-called gems, which we will be hunting as well. And therefore, we will have them as part of your portfolio alongside conventional crypto assets. And we are also adding the direction of NFTs, which open you which are currently rising and are another promising directive of investment. So as a user, you will get access to selected investment opportunities between different kinds of assets to build a balanced portfolio and be able to satisfy your investment needs. The benefit for you as an investor, and this is an important point, because there are benefits for you as a user or as a common investor in who uses our products, which means, and this benefit is broad access and portfolio, but there are also benefits for the businesses who are using our product, because one of our end users as part of the ecosystem is businesses. And for the businesses, the benefits are, one, the fact that we provide for them a comprehensive service, because it's not enough to provide only a technology. You also need to provide all other support, the legal support, the advisory support, financial support, marketing support, for them to be able to conduct their capital raising process. This is what we help them with. Another important thing that plays a huge role in our ecosystem is decentralized secondary trading of securities. So I don't know if you're familiar with it, but the problem with security tokens is that most of them are not traded at all or have quite a narrow liquidity. The problem is that they are securities and therefore they cannot be traded on conventional exchanges. What we did in terms of our research and technology work, we found out that there is possibility to trade securities, security tokens in a decentralized way. Without going a public company, and therefore this is cheaper for businesses. So the unique advantage for businesses and for investors is that security tokens issued with Stobox can be traded on a decentralized market, unlike almost all other kinds of security tokens from other providers. And lastly, speaking about competitive advantages, if you think about us, about Stobox as an investment opportunity, because we have our own STBX token issued, which represents shares in Stobox. We also have STBU token, which powers up our ecosystem, which can be used to pay for our services, which can be to get different discounts, to get ranks in the ecosystem, etc. If you consider from the perspective of this token, then the competitive advantage and the reason why we will be growing at a faster pace than competing products is not only the fact that we provide superior product to businesses, but also the efficient marketing, because one of the challenges in the ecosystem in growing up the tokenization is education of the market. And you do it via content marketing. And we have the strongest content marketing on the market as well. Check out our YouTube channel when we have great educational video best on the market, better than anybody else is doing, which creates trust among businesses who are coming to us and makes it easier for us to grow than any other company. Given the question was complex and had many layers, let me summarize. You get access to, as a business, you get better comprehensive service and opportunity of trading. And as investor in Stobox, you get a company with huge competitive advantages in the emerging market.
Yeah, so I want to mention that we have two directions. The first one is tokenization, and we help our clients, our businesses with consulting, and we're providing for them our technology, our digital securities dashboard, the technical infrastructure for primary issuing of digital securities. And also we help businesses with secondary market of these securities. I want to mention that last week we issued our own STO, Stobox STO, and now everybody can participate. I mean, the investor from Singapore sitting in sofa can invest in private company in USA. And we open these possibilities for their public and institutional investors in a legal way. And we have our share STBX of our company, of our US company. And also we have our crypto direction where we're currently building Stobox Exchange, where we will list their utility tokens of other businesses. Because what we are doing products. First of all, we're doing for ourselves because we want to be presented in blockchain and we want to operate as a company and have the registry of shareholders on blockchain and see it online for our company. And we show for other businesses how they can do with us. And also, we have our utility token, the token of our ecosystem, which will be used for paying the fees on the exchange. Currently, clients paying as for consulting services. In the future, you will pay for secondary market in STBU. And we're building the dual token model where you have your shares and you have your utility token. And it is a very great example about the modern solutions and their modern businesses. Because as, for example, you have your restaurant, yeah? And you can tokenize your shares of your private company, of your network of restaurants, and attract capital to your company. And also, you can have your utility token as a loyalty token. For example, everybody who pay for some food will get 10 tokens. And when you get 100 tokens, you can open a new menu, yeah? And it makes the community more engaged. And it provides more services for your customers and for your community, and you get all of the businesses from this way.
Okay, so I hope that those of you who are watching this video right now have finally understood about the ecosystem of Stobox, especially its real and positive use cases, and of course its competitive advantages and benefits. You know, I'm very impressed with the concept of Stobox so far that you've explained right now. So it's something that most of the people around the world who are into crypto and blockchain really need to check this out. Anyway, guys, I appreciate the way you've shared this to us, so thank you. So let's proceed now with the next question. I certainly believe that one of the key factors that would make the project grow in the long run are partnerships. Okay, so speaking of the partnerships, whether if they are on board or upcoming or both, could you at least name some of these Stobox partners for our subscribers and viewers who are tuning into us in this exclusive interview right now?
Yes, sure. Thank you for the amazing questions. We have several directions of business development focused on building partnership in order to provide a more comprehensive service. One direction is law firms. Our goal is to have partnerships with law firms in many countries in order to be able to set up the necessary corporate structures for tokenization. So we have partnership with law firms in 12 countries, including the US, Germany, Liechtenstein, Switzerland, Ukraine, Honsel. Our law firm partners include, for example, Loeb Smith, lawyers from Cayman Islands, RLP lawyers from Liechtenstein, Legal Factory from Switzerland, etc. The next piece is marketing partners, because the main thing that that businesses need when they come to us is finding the right investors. So we have partnerships with several marketing agencies involved in marketing token offerings, as well as individuals related with the investor relations, with the institutional investors and family offices that help us with closing fundraising campaigns for our clients. One of such partners is the marketing agency Block Relations, for example. Another important piece of partnerships is government partnerships, because in order to enable the ecosystem to thrive, you also need an evolving legislation that makes capital movement easier. So previously, we have been working with the government of Malta, with Malta Digital Innovation Authority, and we were working on the education of business community and written a book in collaboration with them on digital securities. Also, currently, we are more focused on the government of Ukraine. Ukraine is a thriving ecosystem in terms of blockchain, has one of the biggest volumes of P2P transactions and a huge developer community. And currently, there is a preparation of the virtual asset legislation framework regarding which we advise to the government in order how to structure the legislation better. And also, we are participating in the general strategic planning of the development of the virtual asset market with all ones from the government, from the business, and from the community in order to make the market function in a more efficient way. And the last part in terms of our partnerships is exchanges, because even though we provide a decentralized exchange for securities, for some of the clients, what may work for them is centralized exchanges, licensed stock exchanges for their security tokens. So we have partnered with several of them as well. It includes a Cryptos S exchange from Philippines, actually Archax from UK, Tokenize stock exchange from Barbados. So several clients who can help with trading security tokens. To summarize, no one can build something really big alone, and especially when we are speaking about global reduction in barrier of movement of capital. So one of our strategic development is to build strong partnership in order to be able to process a lot of clients simultaneously and satisfy their global needs that our own team won't be able to do alone. And generally, we believe in the win-win mentality, in doing this collaboratively, not the fierce cutthroat competition like it is in some older markets. Sorry for interruption.
Yeah, and also I want to mention exclusive news that next week we will partner with Crypto Valley Association. It is the biggest blockchain community in Europe from Switzerland, where we will be involved in designing the legislation in Europe and discussing tokenization topics with big players such as Signum Bank, Seba Bank, Morgan Stanley, and we will be their active participant of this community. And also regarding our achievements, in 2018, in November, we won the best in Malta Blockchain Summit, we won Asset Tokenization of the Year, like the best tokenization company. And also we wrote a book in collaboration with Malta Digital Innovation Authority about how you can do your STO in a proper way. And I can leave this book for free below in the comments or in the description of the video. And we were one of the top 10 promising startups in 2020, according to EuropeStartups.com. And also, we conducted our own event, Digital Assets Investment Conference, where we attract best speakers around the world and discuss tokenization topics. Because one of our closest contact, it is David Wild from Nasdaq, Doton Romani from London Stock Exchange Group. And we collected speakers from 30 countries and discussed very important topics of the tokenization and the future of this industry with market insights.
Wow. I mean, those are pretty solid partnerships that you have mentioned to us right here on our exclusive interview session. I just hope that these partnerships you have would continue to thrive for a very long time in order for Stobox to become solid even more than ever. And I'm looking forward to the free book that you have mentioned, Ross. So once again, guys, thank you so much for sharing this to us. So let's move on to the next question. I had to admit, though, in my previous interviews right here on YouTube and Facebook Live, most of my guests love to talk about their company or project's achievements. Now, speaking of the achievements, could you guys share some of Stobox's accomplishments from the beginning until now?
Yes, Ross already mentioned some of the achievements in his previous reply regarding the asset tokenization of the year and the general network of collaborations we built. I say another achievement that I want to mention, which may be non-obvious, is the fact the strong research framework that we built. So we did, I'm ready to say 10,000 hours of research in terms of the business models and legal structures for securities tokenization. So one of our strong achievements is this framework that we can apply almost to any company to create an attractive tokenization structure for it. These are, I would say, the strongest points, one of the strongest points that we have, which is then converted into good content that shows in our content marketing and general marketing activities, and leads to the general recognition that we received on the market, which is one of the strong achievements. And it led to a success in business as well. So in the last few months, I think we started to see our efforts slowly paying off, with incoming requests from businesses interested in tokenization increasing, and us receiving more interest in real estate tokenization, in tokenization of different kind of projects. So the next milestones would be to convert this increasing interest and visibility that we received into actual deals. We already have a few deals signed up, and I think you soon will hear about a few companies with whom we are doing tokenization. One of them, according to the financials that we review, is promising a fantastic return on investment. So you should definitely subscribe and look forward to hearing more about our clients. And I hope in future we will see more companies, especially from traditional industries, that are currently on the stages of negotiations and the offer to be converted into the clients for tokenization that you will be able to enjoy as well as your investments.
And also, I want to add that one of the achievements that we already built it, the strong network of media partners. What I mean that we providing the analytical content for free for big players in media industry, for securities.io, for the tokenist, for the tokenizer. We published articles in Cointelegraph, in BTC.news. So we share our expertise and share our vision and our market insights with the businesses, and we educate them how they can participate in this emerging market, and we provide this content for the medias.
All right, so that's great to hear from you guys in sharing about the accomplishments that you have from the beginning until now. I honestly know that it's such a great feeling for you guys to accomplish the stuff that you have mentioned, and hopefully that Stobox will have more achievements in the next few months or years or so. So well done to you guys. So let's proceed with the next question. I know that aside from the achievements that you have shared to us right here on this exclusive interview session, we are also facing challenges as well. No matter what aspect of life are we in, challenges are always there and we're not exempted from it. Now guys, could you share about the recent challenges that you are facing from the beginning until now, and how do you guys cope up with that?
One strong challenge that we had was the challenge of adapting the technology to regulatory requirements, because these requirements have been constantly evolving and we had to pivot several times in terms of which kind of blockchain we choose and how specifically we set up the infrastructure in order to make the requirement more efficient, in order to reduce the legal barriers for us and for our clients. So this is one of the challenges that unfortunately slowed us down and delayed go-to-market. Another challenge that we are currently facing is education of the market, because nobody knows what tokenization is. This, on one hand, is a challenge, and on the other hand, is an opportunity. This is a challenge because you need to do a lot of work on proactively reaching out to clients and educating them on what tokenization is and how it works, on creating content, on answering their objections, etc. So this is a lot of work of sales team and content team, and a lot of effort put into educating clients about the solution. The opportunity is that there is a huge piece of market that is untapped and unclaimed by any tokenization provider. In more mature market and older markets, you get a fierce cutthroat competition, and which make profit margins much lower for companies, which means that you have to fight for each customer fiercely with other competitors, and you cannot get as much profit from it. While in our case, when the market is very early and it is emerging, there is opportunity to grow very fast and to conquer vast areas of the market, of geography, of market niches, to have very significant profit margins. So we have this blue ocean that we can basically conquer. This is one of the reasons why we are currently doing a fundraising campaign to get more money for faster growth and to be one of the first to leverage this and to gain to grasp this opportunity that we are currently presented with.
And also I want to mention that we faced the development challenges, because previously we worked with contractors, yes, with external team, and that's why we have some delays and inefficiently. And that's why we currently built our in-house development team, which can develop our all products of Stobox: Stobox Dashboard, Stobox Digital Security Swap, and Stobox Exchange. And now we see that it is much better for us from the development side.
Wow, I mean, that's really inspiring on how you guys cope up with those challenges to make Stobox grow even more. Let's just hope that you guys would remain consistent no matter if those challenges are on the next level. That's what you guys have been doing this day. So once again, thank you so much for sharing that to us. So let's move on to the next question. Okay, so this is something that most of the crypto and blockchain enthusiasts are looking forward to these days, especially Stobox. The ones that I'm talking about are the project's future plans, exciting updates, and some little spoilers for the community. So guys, if you don't mind, could you share some of the exciting updates of future plans and maybe a bit of spoilers for our amazing subscribers and viewers who are watching us right now?
Sure. There is a lot coming on forward in the next few months, so you should definitely stay subscribed. One of the things, one of the most important, is our fundraising campaign. So we are opening an investment campaign into our Wyoming company with tokenized shares. So you still have an opportunity to invest in our corporation and therefore get opportunity to be exposed to our growth and to the growth of the market. And more importantly, after we close this campaign, I assume it will be around in 3 months, we will launch the secondary trading of our private shares, which is something that almost nobody is doing. So this is quite an exciting opportunity. And I assume that that share price will even further increase after we open the secondary trading. Another important thing is the launch of our exchange. So in a few months, we will be also launching a Stobox crypto exchange and conducting some exciting listing. So you will get an opportunity to be one of the first traders to leverage the great terms of being part of the Stobox exchange. Also, we will probably have a few of our first clients launching their STOs as well, with very lucrative investment opportunities. And lastly, we will be setting up our growth channels, testing the growth tactic in order to have even more clients. And after we finish the fundraising campaign, set up trading so that we could provide you with even more investment opportunities, with even more fantastic tokens. And so that if you invest in Stobox, you would be able to profit even more.
And also, I want to mention that in a month, we will issue our own NFTs. We will issue Stobox merchandise in form of NFT, because we created in cooperation with a famous designer from Asia, Stobox Lucky Bull. And Stobox, because we have a Stobox 0x, like a Ethereum wallet, right? And we see that NFT market emerging as well, and everybody can participate in a few months and buy Stobox merch in NFT form and then redeem the physical one.
Wow, that's very nice to hear coming from you guys about the exciting updates, future plans, and other stuff that would make the community excited even more. So I'm really looking forward to these exciting updates that would mean a bright future ahead for Stobox. So that's going to be great, guys. I will be looking forward to those NFTs that you've mentioned. So thank you so much for sharing this to me and to our viewers right here. Okay, now let's move forward to my final question for this exclusive interview. Okay, so assuming that our viewers here are watching us right now are encountering Stobox for the first time. So here's the thing. Give us some reasons why we should be grabbing the opportunity to check out Stobox right now rather than later. Like, what is it for us if we're going to check them out today, or what we could miss if we're not on board with this?
Oh, this is very simple. All businesses have two stages: the stage of preparation and setting up, and the stage of growth. On this first stage, their value, the value of their token, are relatively flat with minor fluctuation. And later, when they go to the growth stage, when they do start active marketing, etc., they start growing like this, exponentially. And currently, we are on this transition stage. And the fact that we are speaking with you, for example, is one of the signs that we are transitioning to the growth stage, doing more marketing and more public exposure. So each day, is the risk for you that you will miss the appreciation and the growth that will be happening to STBX and the CBU. And you should definitely not miss it, and do not miss the growth that tokenization market will have in general.
All right, so you've heard it from our guests today on why we should be checking out Stobox today rather than later. So hopefully they have answered all the questions they have asked him in our exclusive interview, and no doubt that we've learned so much from them. So thank you very much for that, Borys. Okay, so before we end, do you have any parting words for our subscribers and viewers here on YouTube?
Sure. Thank you for inviting us. Thank you for being such an amazing community and for your genuine interest in good projects. And I hope that we will be able to provide you many fantastic projects that you will be able to support and that will create a genuine economic value and will increase your wealth as well. So thank you for being with us.
Yeah, thank you for inviting, and I wish for all of your subscribers and your viewers to catch this year Stobox Lucky Bull.
All right, so there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our special guest for today, the co-founders of Stobox, the Chief Operating Officer, Mr. Ross Shemeliak, and the Head of Business Analytics and Strategy, Mr. Borys Pikalov. Once again, guys, thank you so much for your time with us here in the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for inviting us. It was fantastic. And thank you for great questions.
All right. And also, I would like to thank all of our subscribers and viewers here who are watching this exclusive interview with Ross and Borys, the co-founders of Stobox. I hope you guys have learned so much from them. So if you have any questions that were not answered yet right here in this exclusive interview, I would invite you guys to leave down your comments right here on this video. And of course, if you like what you've seen right here so far, kindly don't hesitate or think twice in sharing this exclusive interview video to your crypto, blockchain, and DeFi friends out there. And one more thing, peeps, I'm inviting you all to smash the like button, hit subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for you to stay notified about my latest videos and interviews regarding cryptocurrencies, blockchain technology, and DeFi. And you can also follow my social media channels right here or in my YouTube description. Okay, guys, so from my freaking home studio, this is Jeff, aka Nomad Fury, and see you all in my next video. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Thank you, Ross. Thank you, Borys.
Thank you. Stay tuned.
Thank you.